I mean, every time I prepare bolognese, I have enough leftover to feed a small nation. So since I haven't done that in a very long time, I'm going to do like a cooking vlog. I mean, I'm going to prepare some bolognese, but it's going to be a special bolognese sauce because I got this from a friend of mine. He's producing like chorizo, beef tapas. You know, especially during this pandemic, a lot of people had to come out with some kind of businesses they can do at home. And of course, I always like to support those people with this entrepreneurial spirit, especially if they're friends of mine. So of course, I got it yesterday. I met him yesterday and he gave me also some free beef tapa.
So what's that, the beef?
Oh.
That's good. You have a lot of products na.
Tolo pa, pork tapa, beef tapa, and kanang chorizo, pero nahurot na gawang pork tapa today.
So thank you for this, ha?
Sige.
Sige, amping bro.
Salamat,
you take
salamat.
Care.
Nga, ingna ko sa imong kwan sa chorizo, ha, para like, I will improve it.
Sige, I will let you know.
Thank
sige.
You.
Salamat, boss.
He also gave me this for free. Thank you so much, bro. I really appreciate it. Well, yeah, let's get started. Okay, I'm starting to add all the meat first. It was like 4 packs. Just like this. I know a lot of people like to start their bolognese sauce with the vegetables, but not me. Well, I like to give the meat a nice golden brown color, so yeah, I'm going to cook it properly, starting with the pork first, and then I'm going to add the beef. And then meanwhile it's cooking, I can start chopping, starting with the celery. Okay, and I'm done with the celery. And I guess we're on a good point with the pork also. Look at this. Yeah, we started to get some color. At this point, I'm gonna add the beef. I like my pork well cooked. It needs more time than the beef, that's why the pork first and then the beef. More or less the same quantity, more or less 50-50. Okay, and let's give it a nice color. While it's cooking, let's keep chopping. Next thing I need, carrots. And the carrots, done. And next, onions. Oh gosh. And that's why I always keep the onions for last. That's a lot of chopping. But I'm done with it. Look at this. Oh, you see? Nice golden brown color. That's what I'm looking for. At this point, I can go in one by one with the veggies. I'm going to start with the celery. And I'm going to cook it a little bit. Let's give it a few minutes. And then I'm going to go with the carrots and then the onions. I don't want to add it all together. I just want to make sure they cook properly. A lot of bolognese. Okay, as you see, the meat is golden brown, the vegetables are translucent. What does it mean? We can go in with the tomato sauce. So I have here like diced tomato. Get all of this, okay? Water. Oh, nice and clean. Hey! That's really a lot. But it's okay. I'm going to add also some black pepper, a couple of those. Chicken broth cubes, a couple of those also. A little mix. Cover it, and then we just forget about it. Actually, no, we still need to go back once in a while to stir it a little bit. I like to cook it long, 1 or even 1.5 hours, maybe even 2 hours. The more, the better, actually. I'm getting hungry. Look at this beauty.
Oh, I know, right?
That's what I'm talking about. So it's just simmering slowly, slowly, 1.5 hours right now. It's nice and reduced, and I'm getting hungry. So let's boil some pasta, and it's ready to go. You know, this is actually a lot of work and it takes a while, but it's so worth it. Oh yeah, not bad with the chorizo, something different, yeah. Oh my God, it's so good. Some parmesan, some extra virgin olive oil. This is seriously good. Anyway, I'm not done there in the kitchen yet, but I'm going to finish this first and then back to the kitchen. I mean, it's a lot of work, it takes time, so why prepare it only a little bit? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it in those plastic bags. I mean, every time I prepare bolognese, I have enough leftover to feed a small nation. So this is how I do it. I portion it. One bag is one portion. And then I make it nice and flat. Trying to remove all the air. I seal it. And here we have it. And then I store it here in the freezer, you see? All the packs, like this. You know, they're very easy to store. You can just do like, to have like different sauces, one for bolognese, one for tomato sauce, one for bechamel sauce, or anything, and you just store it there. And you just take out what you need, like books. It's like your library here. I mean, like that, it can stay here for months. It's not going to stay for months though. I'm going to take care of it earlier. I mean, if you prepare bolognese, I'm telling you, prepare a lot of it and then you just freeze it. It's not worth it to just prepare like a few portions for, I mean, it's a lot of work, it takes time, so yeah, that's my tip. You're welcome. I hope you enjoyed. Please give it a like, subscribe, guys, subscribe. A lot of you are not subscribing yet. I really would like to encourage you to subscribe. I mean, at least consider it, okay? See you the next time.